When the weather gets warmer, you can expect area golf courses to be filled with local golfers. Golf is especially important to the folks who work at the Tennessee Golf Association's Golf House, Tennessee. It's a facility where you can learn all about the history of golf in Tennessee.
We've been here since 1995. The Hall of Fame was started in 1991, and then we secured this property for our home site of all of golf in Tennessee. So we have administrative offices, the Tennessee Junior Golf Academy, and the Tennessee Golf Hall of Fame are all housed in this property here. The Hall of Fame has currently 50 members of the Hall of Fame. We're getting ready to have a huge induction dinner for our 51st member. Is going to be for Dick Horton, which will be in February, and he's the one that had the dream to create this full home site, the Hall of Fame, and so his dinner is going to be really big. He was here for 45 years, and this was his dream to have this home site, and just decided to retire last year.
What is the criteria, I guess, that you all use as far as inducting new members?
We have a committee that the public can nominate someone to be elected into the Tennessee Golf Hall of Fame. Their championship golf record is one of the primary criteria, service to the game. Some of our Hall of Fame members were great administrators, volunteers, and benefactors. Some of them have made wonderful donations to make this property available. Vince Gill is one of our biggest supporters. He loves junior golf. Jack Lupton out of Chattanooga actually helped us build all this property here that's today.
Do you also have like just golfers who were very talented athletes as well?
Yes. Dr. Kerry Middlecoff is probably our most famous golfer. He won two U.S. Opens in the 50s and the Masters. He's our only Hall of Fame member that has won the Masters as of right now, but we hope to have some in the future. A lot of collectibles from our Hall of Fame are in the front two rooms, but we have memorabilia and photographs spread throughout the building. We like to highlight as many golfers as we possibly can. When we get to the back of the building, that's kind of our junior golf hub. During the summer, we have junior golf camp, so we'll have average of 50 golfers spending the night here all throughout the summer. That being said, they also have camps, clinics going on outside on the golf course for the young golfers. They start them at age 4, and their clinics are more like 30 minutes, and they do not spend the night. We love to have kids here during the summer. During the winter, it's not quite as busy as it would be during the summer, but we open the doors to anybody. It's not a private facility. It's a junior golf learning center, but it is open to adults as well.
Do you have to love golf almost to work here and be affiliated with this museum, would you say?
We are all very proud of the facility, and we enjoy our jobs. Myself, I'm not a huge golfer, but I love golf. And a lot of us work too much to enjoy the game like we would like to. But everybody enjoys the history. We enjoy teaching. We enjoy the access, opening access to families.
What are some of the main goals that you guys have as an organization?
Promoting golf to youth and the disadvantaged is our primary goal. But we have figured out the more comfortable you feel when you arrive at the golf course, probably you'll play longer throughout your life. And so we try to make it accessible to everybody and fun and friendly. You know, the younger you can start, more comfortable you're going to feel. So that's why we try to just have access and provide funding for that access.
The Golf House Tennessee Museum is open to the public March through December. The weekday hours are from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. The museum and adjacent golf course are located at 400 Franklin Road in Franklin, Tennessee. If you love golf and the history of the game featuring Tennesseans, this would be a wonderful place for you to check out. Reporting from Williamson County, Barry Hyatt, NCTV.